one frames I'm making. That job I did yesterday where I was showing you the frames that aren't really frames. Anyway, I thought maybe you'd be interested in seeing how one of these frames go together. I guess I'm building what I would call an archetypal frame, meaning that this is the kind that you're supposed to see. Not like that one from yesterday. I suppose I have advantage of a nail gun, which they didn't have, and I don't know if it's an advantage or not, because actually it's highly likely you're going to see this gun misfire and the nail shoot off to the side, as is common with nail guns and pine, like that's what this is. Clamp puts pressure on my two jams, my jam legs, so that I can place this stool at the proper height. You know, this is where I'm working on getting my blind stop here going, and this is just a cutoff from my blind stop. I'm just using that as a gauge. Go ahead and nail that. I know it's the right height. Parting bead right there. I cut that ahead of time and I put it in my parting bead channel so that when I put my header piece on, that parting bead channel actually goes into the channel of the parting bead in the leg and just helps with alignment. This is the material I'm using is KDAT pine, and KDAT is the acronym for kiln dried after treatment. So, there's one of those nails shooting out. You gotta be careful when you're using these nail guns. It's easy to shoot your finger.
Yeah.
Ask me how I know.
Yeah.
That's how you learn where to put your hands in these, right? When you're trying to pull this nail out, but it's not working. I guess these are too sharp. Is that what's going on? So now I've got my blind stops here. Blind stops were one of the things that were missing from the one we did yesterday. So All right, so here, this is a cool trick, right? So actually here, I'm gonna square up these ends with a chop saw real quick. This is the technique I typically use. Put these blind stops on. Look, see, I'm gonna mark it here, there. They're gonna cut it out, okay? They gotta mark it there, and then I'll get this on the other side too, so you can see. I put my pencil here, just as a gauge that I want this outside edge to be flush with the outside there. So boom, I just do that. Mark it on the underside.
Both at the same time.
Cool. Alright, and then I'll take, just use my handsaw. Do the rest of this. Right, so. If you notice on the saw, I've got big teeth and little teeth. The big teeth are for going with the grain. The little teeth are going across the grain. And this. Isn't that nice?
Fits really nice.
Wait to get this one done. It's freaking hot in here, man.
Sweating just standing here.
What's that?
Sweating just standing here for.
I know. It's like, man.
Oh, really good. There's a fan there that's not on that. So.
Turn that guy on.
Yeah, now that you're almost done.
Yeah, I'm almost done. Look at those nails up there. See those? Shot, how they shot out. That's the disadvantage of a nail gun and pine. Yeah. Using hand drives. Maybe like they used to use in the old school days. Probably wouldn't have that problem. You know, but.
Hey, could make it the painter's problem, but we're the painters.
Well, that's the advantage in that. Yeah, let's go. Hand to make sure I didn't shoot any nails out. Last of all, ten degrees. All right, then I have a mark here. I'm gonna go there, but I'm gonna go a little bit shy because my first mark I made wasn't what I wanted. That's the advantage of being your own painter.
Yeah.
Walk on out the van and put it in. That'll be the end of that video, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah. Okay.
On the saw guides.
Oh man, look at all that rigid and pestle stuff in here.
I don't know, man.
I had to throw that in there.